In Nepal, in the shadow of Mount Manaslu, he had terrible panic attacks.
I have a lot of fear about the snowstorm when the thunder comes. And I fear for strangers. And one day my father said, "Oh, you want to learn meditation, right?" The first meditation technique is he asked me to watch my breath. So I watch my breath.
That's a common mindfulness exercise. And soon, Mingyur was a mindfulness meditation prodigy. Decades later, he built this monastery in Bodh Gaya, India, the place where the Buddha famously achieved enlightenment while meditating under a tree. He spent 4 years wandering the Himalayas, practicing mindfulness, and growing a beard. And then, scientists invited him to Wisconsin so they could look at his brain. They found that although he was 41, he had the brain of a 33-year-old. When they had him go in an fMRI machine and cultivate a sense of compassion by meditating, the activity in his empathy circuits shot up 700 to 800%. One of the researchers later wrote, "Such an extreme increase befuddles science. The closest resemblance is in epileptic seizures, but brains are seized by seizures, in contrast to Mingyur's intentional control of his brain activity." Mingyur Rinpoche had somehow induced a prolonged attack of compassion in his own brain. When the researchers studied the brainwaves of a whole group of long-term meditators, they found similar results. The moment meditation began, there was a sudden rush of activity. Meditation causes big changes in the minds of experts. But when beginners meditate, not much happens. These observations seem to back up a long-held claim that meditation can make you a master of your own mind. Early Buddhist texts say this can help end suffering. Modern headlines are a bit more clinical, claiming mindfulness may cure anxiety, depression, and a whole host of other health problems. So,